hair. The first is what we will be doing tonight. I reserve box dye for the impatient situation in which I've got roots coming in, but I want to film a video the next day and look nice, and I don't want to wait for Wella to arrive in the mail, so I just run to CVS and buy this, and it gets the job done. I know it's not the best for your hair, so when I feel like I'm all over losing pigmentation, my hair from root to tip just looks like a much duller red than what I prefer, what I do is I take one part Wella Professionals Cream Developer 6% or 20 volume 6% or 20 volume developer, and my bowl is going to be half of that, and then half of a mixture of these two pigments. They're both from the Vibrant Reds collection. This one is 7744, and this one is 7743. Intense Medium Blonde / Red Red. Intense Medium Blonde / Red Gold. Zest, and this provides a deeper, richer red, and I really love the combination. I have not been using those so much in quarantine because I like how this lighter, natural ginger shade looks on me better when I have no makeup on, but I prefer the vibrant, intense red when I have makeup on, and I just haven't had makeup on much, so yeah, I'm going to get this all set up. And we can get started applying it to my roots. Oh, wait. I don't think I even told you anything about it. It's the L'Oreal Paris. You can get this at pretty much any Target, Walmart, CVS. So the shade 6R, light auburn. Excellence Cream Triple Protection Color, Ceramide Plus Pro Keratin Plus Collagen, 100% resistant gray coverage, rich radiant color, revitalized hair level 3 permanent, 1 application, 2 to 8 weeks intensive care, super rich care, or super rich color. And you can see here what your results might be. From blonde or brown to medium brown, you get varying shades of red, depending on what base you're starting with. And my red tends to fade out pretty quickly because I have a base of blonde underneath it. This pre-color treatment, you're only meant to apply to the ends because those tend to be most dry and vulnerable. Permanent color cream. So we're gonna mix these two. I always find this part so fun. You unscrew it and it's sealed. But this bulky part will unseal it for you if you remove this, then this bulky part will stab in. Squeeze in as much of that out of the tube as we can manage. Don't want a drop to go to waste. And then precise applicator tip or a comb applicator tip, and we will be using neither. My favorite method for applying to the roots is one of these application brushes. It just really lets you get it precisely where you want. This one is by Sleek Shop. Protection from rogue globs of hair dye getting on my neck and chest and arms and staining them orange, and like the back of the neck especially. No good. Keeps me safe. Okay, so I'm going to part my hair roughly where I usually do because that's the spot that's most important. Before we start applying the dye, I'm going to take a touch of Vaseline on my fingertips, and dabble it along the skin surrounding my hairline to protect it from stains. One last mix, making sure everything's all combined. I made a troubling discovery yesterday that percolated does not mean and has never meant what I thought it did. I've always used it as like meaning like letting an idea sort of marinate in your head, like let me let that thought percolate for a while, or making sure something is completely evenly distributed throughout, like, oh, I've got to get the hair dye completely percolated in my hair. No. I looked it up and it, like most words, has multiple meanings, but the most widely understood definition means like making coffee, like something filled. that's always the worst, to realize that there's probably been many situations throughout your life where people were kind of caught off guard by something you said, but did not correct you. Alright, that main section looks pretty good, so I'm gonna move on to the next part. Super thorough with this. I think a lot of people, when they're tying their roots, are really making sure they're getting the entirety of every last section. But I think that only really matters if you're into doing hairstyles, like different sorts of braids and half up, half downs that are going to be giving the world glimpses of secret little tucked away spots. Sometimes in a ponytail, so I'm sure to get under the back there. But besides that, I really just focus on where I part my hair and then like framing my face. The sideburns are crucial. I like to kind of wiggle the brush around in there to make sure I'm getting them from all sides. I feel like I always miss an angle. This might be highly scandalous, but I do oftentimes, with excess dye, apply it to my eyebrows. I do use a Q-tip instead of the brush for extra precision, because I do know that if even the tiniest, tiniest droplet of hair dye were to find its way into my eyeball, it'd be no good at all. But I just think it makes my eyebrow makeup come through a lot more brightly and gingery on a base of lighter eyebrows than on a base of brown eyebrows. I think that should do it for that side. Flipping over. Okay. Alright, rock. I didn't miss any spots around here. Okay, next section. Do any of you dye your hair? I would love to hear any hair dyeing stories, mundane or catastrophic. Been dyeing my hair since I was 11. When I was in 6th grade, my mom was taking fashion design classes, and as her final project at the end of the semester, she had to showcase her collection was all clothing for young girls, and so I got to model one of her dresses, and the dress would be better suited for blonde hair, and as you can see from my roots, my hair is dark, and so she took me to get blonde highlights, and yeah, pretty much since then. Hot pink, it's been platinum blonde, and then darker honey money. Lately, every time I've purchased a new bundle of hair ties, I've thrown away this weird, like, plastic loop because I didn't read the packaging and didn't know what it was for. But it's a nifty little hair tie holder, organizer, thingamajig. I feel guilty that I neglected it for so long. It's really very useful. It'll still be a bit of a challenge. Can't see too well. I can kind of feel it out. Behind the ear. Behind the ear is a crucial spot as well. Easy to miss. But very easy to spot. By people standing behind you. Sides down, so now let's finish it up with the very back. This isn't really a necessary step, but I find it fun to just kind of smooth everything down. Remember exactly how long. So we must consult the directions. We found the part that applies to us. Root application. If you do color every 4 to 6 weeks with the same or similar shade, 20 minutes. Then it says to apply remaining product. Going to make use of them for eyebrow application just because they make nice sounds. I'm just brushing the hairs back to make sure I'm getting a 360 application, coating them from every angle. Okay, good. Wipe up, wipe up any excess underneath the brow. Okay. Going to let that process for 10 minutes. Okay, let's pretend I'm shampooing. I'm going to wrap my hair in the classic towel hat to help it dry off a bit. I like to use this Olaplex number 6 Bond Smoother Leave-In Reparative Styling Cream. Reduces frizz, nourishes, and protects. But it likes to be applied. I love the way this feels on my skin. It's so jelly-like. And on top of that, I'm going to apply the Olin Nixon Truth Serum Collagen Boosted with Collagen Boosted. Apply evenly to the hair has finally reached a more damp rather than wet state, I'm going to apply my Olaplex number 6 Bond Smoother comb through and style as desired. I don't like to comb my hair. I just don't like what happens when I do that. So I just find that it's really what helps get my waves most defined and least puffy and frizzy. It's kind of like lemongrassy, I think. Very fresh citrus scent. Other side, I think I've still got quite enough product on my hands to go around to the other side. Specifies mid-length ends. I can't resist scrunching it up a little further. Oh my god, I smell so good. So that's what I like to do for my hair before going to bed. Hi, good morning. I just woke up. This is what my hair looks like after spending the night air drying. And as you can see, no more roots. Very exciting. I wish I had some more time, because I would prefer to show you guys my whole routine of like curling my whole head of hair. I always use the Icon Air. It's the 1-inch curler. But I overslept and actually have to get out of here. Not super fast, but I have enough hair that curling all of it is pretty time consuming. So instead, we're just going to do my more natural wavy hair routine and throw on a bit of makeup before I head out the door. So I'm going to brush this all out. And now that it's all brushed, I'm going to part it where I would like. I am going to use the Olaplex number 7 bonding oil, which doubles as a sort of nourishing, shininess enhancing hair oil, as well as a heat protectant. Dabble a bit of that on my hands, rub it between my palms, and then work it through just the ends of my hair. If you take it up too far, your hair will, you know, look greasy, like it needs to be washed, and we just want it to look super shiny and healthy, so just focusing on those dry ends. I also like that it adds a bit more definition to my waves. A fuzzy puffball, and the oil separates out the wave pattern a little bit more. Separates out the waves a little bit more. Okay. And then I think
think I have time to just add a couple of curls to the top. I think it's really common for a lot of people who have wavier curly hair for the for it to be more intense in the lower layers of the hair, and then on top it's straighter. So when I don't have time to curl all of my hair, but I want to spruce it up a bit, I'll just grab some of these straighter top sections and add a bit of va-va-voom. Curling, facing away from the face. Maybe I should also do this face framing bit. Okay, and then brush through them with my fingers to soften them out and blend them in. Sorry about all the background noise. I hope it is nice. Nice ambiance. Okay. That's good. And that front piece. Okay. What should I wear? Lately I've been wearing this little black shirt, like one of those tight black shirts with the ribbed texture and like ruffle sleeves, with a strapless dress over it. I think I might do that. I'm going to apply this CeraVe Broad Spectrum. Leaves those like indentations. Next is blush. This is Orgasm by NARS. I really like the color, but I find that it doesn't apply super evenly. I find it getting sort of like patchy sometimes, so I would not necessarily recommend it. But you know, for the eyebrows, I'm taking this little baby angled brush and a matte medium orange toned powder, just very lightly sweeping that over the brows and blending. I'm just filling in any gaps. Okay. Oh, I hate when that happens. A flake fell on my cheek. You gotta wait for those to dry, because if you try to take them off while they're wet, it will transform like a werewolf from just a tiny speck. Doing. and I never overline my lips. Does not really work on me, but what I do like to do is apply a bit of extra to the upper lip. I love how well this lip color matches the blush. Sort of just a very similar. Oh, never mind. They look pretty similar on my face though. I'm just going to put on some earrings and perfume and then head out. Just really sweet, fruity, and delicious, but not too overpowering. And I like to put a spritz on the top.